Hello, hello, it's Jang here with a look at a LEGO Creator set. This is Red Creatures. Comes with 221 pieces. It is a 3-in-1 set, and this is the first build, the primary build, the one that they feature on the box, and the one that they kind of feature as the main thing of the entire set. As you can see, it is a red dragon, dark red wings, and just a regular red color for most of the rest of the thing. Just giving you some looks at some different angles. There's a ton of articulation to this thing, with the tail, with the legs, with the arms, with the wings even. There's a lot that you can do to pose this thing up however you want to. So that's the main thing that I'm gonna focus on in this video. First though, I wanna give you a closer look at some of the parts. This head to me is fantastic. It has a very traditional Chinese style to it, especially with the eyes and just the shortness of the skull, how broad the nose is. Looks very celebratory. Makes me think of a lot of Chinese New Year's Day parades. You've got, of course, the ability to open up the mouth a little bit like that. I love the use of those baroque eyes and the bright green color. This looks good from all angles. See, it's also got some horns back there at the back. You do have claws all the way around, just doubles for the hands, claws down on the feet. They don't quite touch the ground, but they kind of get the general idea across pretty well. It has a nice spread to it. And there's a look at your tail. So like I said, let's focus on the articulation and what you can do with this thing. First of all, the spine can be really just curved way up. You can turn it into, look at that, scorpion tail style. You can bring the neck up, couple ratchets. The head, look at that, look how far up the head can turn. You can turn completely vertical. That's ridiculous. Of course, you can also bring it down. This allows you to kind of go double, so you can go two different ways. You can curve part down and then curve part up to give kind of a wavy look to any of these. So that's really nice so far. Wings, I think, would be a good thing to look at next. Wings can be brought up this far. You can bring these fully up like that for just something that you don't usually see. Kind of exposes some of the parts used underneath. But you can bring down just the tips for kind of a gull wing sort of look, a little bit more of a diving kind of look. You can bring these down, so it's kind of using the wings to help hold it onto the ground. You can bring these down to here and then bring the tips up just a little bit. Lots of different possibilities there, obviously. Then we get to the legs. Just so much you can do to pose this thing. It's ridiculous. The legs have ball joints, large ball joints for the upper point, and then you get just a single axis of motion for kind of the lower extremity here. So nothing too fancy there, but it does allow you to splay the legs out and still have the feet all the way on the ground. See how far I can bring that out? You can also bring it out like this, lay it down to the ground, push that back up. And then for the front legs, or the arms, if you will, just bring these legs, the rear ones, back around. These have ball joints, so the smaller style of ball joints for the shoulder and also for the claws, for kind of the hands, if you will. So these can be rotated around, and then the hands can be kind of just posed however you want them to be set up. So you can get this thing to nicely stand up, so it's very upright, like so, if you want to, or you can get it down low into a flying pose. Look at how flat that is, something more like that, but this looks much better from above. You can kind of rotate those feet around just a little bit, decide how much you want the feet to hang down, but that's a pretty cool model just by itself, but there are still two more builds. Well now, that's not a dragon, or anything remotely like a dragon. That's a scorpion. Props to the designer for coming up with such a dramatic change, such a dramatic transformation using the exact same pieces. This does use most of the pieces in the set, just a bunch of little ones are left over. But gosh, it's so great to have available so many joints in a set to be able to make other different things. Now, these pinchers are not able to close up all the way, but they are able to open up, so you can kind of get a little bit of grabbing there. You can see it's got the eyes down in the center. It's got a couple little fangs sticking out there. The forward legs, or kind of the arms, are able to rotate inward and outward like this, which is fine. You know, I don't really need those to go up and down quite so much because these are able to go up and down. The kind of lower arm pieces or lower leg pieces there. So you are able to get that more aggressive upward move, upward pose. Sorry about that. There we go. That's what I was trying to go for. Yeah, I like that. And then you still have a bunch of different joints to play around with back here because they put the ball joints in close. So these are able to kind of rotate around in different ways and you can really get the legs to go back or forward. And then you've got the ratcheting joints here in the center. So the legs are able to come up more like that or they're able to flatten out. So you still get a lot of poseability there. You just got to kind of find the sweet spots there. And I appreciate that. It really allows you to change around the look and the overall pose of the thing. That's just the more upright kind of look. And of course you can bring the tail down and uncoil the tail for just a normal kind of walking around sort of setup there. Bring these legs down onto the ground. Yeah, this is another really good build. I mean, they could have made this, I think, into the primary thing right on the front of the box because I think it looks great and it works great. And especially with the tail coiled up like that. Yeah, that's cool. But there is one more build left in this set, one more official build, so let's check that out. Ha! Very different yet again. A creepy, slithery snake this time with a big ol' head. Yeah, this is definitely should put emphasis on the creepy with this one. It's not a realistic thing. This is beyond. This is definitely well into the fantasy world with the look of it, but it's pretty successfully done. The tough thing about this one is that it has so much weight in that big old head that if you lean it forward any farther than this in its striking position, it is going to just fall forward. There it goes. See, it's not able to hold itself up very well. So that's a little bit of a disappointment there that you're not able to get it closer to the ground. They do use up a lot of joint pieces for all of the length of the tail. So you're able to get this to turn out there and turn out there. You can see that there's a little bit of asymmetry to it. You can coil this up a little bit and that will still hold up, but you really need to worry about the balance of the thing. It doesn't look good to me with it straight like that. I want to always have some kind of curvature there and it's a little bit tough to get that to work. So let's get it down on the ground. What do you think of that by comparison? It's different, a different way of looking at it. Certainly, it doesn't stand up. It certainly sits much better than it stands. So this works better as far as posing the thing is concerned. Closer look at the head, I guess, does still have a jaw that's able to open up, closes up. It's got two sets of teeth there. Still got the same eyes used throughout all of them. Just a little bit more awkward this one is. So to me, I'm actually gonna go for the scorpion as being my favorite looking one, although the dragon build, I think, has the most playability and poseability. It's more versatile. But which one of these is your favorite build of these three from the set? And what do you think about the set on the whole? Please do share your thoughts about it down in the comments section. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. I hope that it was enjoyable for you and I hope that you'll stick around to check out more of my videos because more reviews as well as custom builds are on the way. So I'll be talking to you again very soon. Bye for now.